It's ultimate judgment.
No non-tuners?
Everyone enjoys Eevee.
You go through 20 turns in a single turn.
My entire collection. Thus far.
For Ant-Man 816's contest.
A little cross-hatching and some contour line.
Pop quiz.
I'm off to write some more ideas for video.
Oh my god. YugiTubers? Ultimate Judgment here.
Hi, how are you?
I just wanted to share a deck dissection with you and let you see it. It is another traditional. I know they may not be your thing. So, what we have here are 3 gift cards. Your opponent gains 3,000 life points.
Cool!
Most other builds may not be too useful to you. 3 Legacy of Yadagarasu. Good and traditional because of its second effect, but mostly just here for the draw power. And then you guessed it. Thanks to the gift card, it kind of gave it away. But we have 3 Bad Reaction to Somochi. Anytime that you gain life points, your opponent does, that is, they instead take damage. Haha, that's just so cool. We like totally burn through the opponent's life point. We have 3 Jar of Greed. Draw a card. 3 Good Goblin Housekeeping. All you do is count the number of copies that are in your grave, draw a card, and then draw an additional one for each copy that's in your grave. Then you take 1 card from your hand each time you play one of these, and you put it to the bottom of your deck. 3 Reckless Greed for the draw. 3 Dark World Dealings for the draw power. Draw a card, discard a card. Your opponent does the same. Okay. We have another, like, almost burn card, but it's not really, unless you have your Bad Reaction Somochi going. It's also rather useful because it lets you draw a card and they just gain 1,000. You have Bad Reaction to Somochi out. Instead of gaining 1,000, they take 1,000. Then we have 2 Reload just for the extra bit of draw. Reload is fine. Painful choice. Choose 5 cards from your deck. Let them choose one. All the others go to the graveyard. The other one they chose goes to your hand. Then you've got Foolish Burial, which lets you send a monster from your deck into your graveyard. You know this guy. Pot of Greed. Draw 2 cards. Graceful Charity. Draw 3 cards. Discard 2. Pot of Benevolence. Choose 2 cards in your graveyard. Shuffle them into your deck. You get to only use 1 Pot of Benevolence per turn. You banish Pot of Benevolence. Pot of Duality. You're not going to really be special summoning in this build. Like, there won't be a lot that will actually be summoned. No downside. You really are better off just keeping 1 in the build. And if you want to side deck another, feel free. There's not going to be any side deck in this one either. Card destruction. Draw. And destructing of cards, you know? Like, stuff and such. Pot of Avarice. Get 5 monster cards in your graveyard. And shuffle them into your deck. Draw 2 cards. Simple as can be. And then if you want to talk about discarding cards and good targets for discarding, remember, discarding, not sending, but Brow, Huntsman of Dark World, is very, very nice because if he's discarded from your hand by your own card effect, you draw a card. If he's discarded from your hand by your opponent's card effect, you draw 2 cards because it was their card effect, not yours. Thunder Dragon, send it to the graveyard and look for 2 more copies of it. Up to 2 more. Maintain your hand. What can I say? He lets you activate traps during the same turn he's sent to the graveyard. Awesome. Your turn, your opponent's turn, any time that the activation is right, there's not many downsides. And he almost has his own engine going if you consider him, Graceful Charity, and Painful Choice, along with whatever trap cards you want to be playing in that build. There's engines in traditional format as well. Sinister Serpent, really, really great to be discarding. Because so long as he's in your grave during standby phase, he lets you send himself back to your hand optionally. Like, favorite, comment, PM, and if you see fit, subscribe. And don't forget, make video responses. I would not mind. I always enjoy feedback. I know sometimes that can be rather odd to
to say the least. I do try to do these voices and somewhat a little bit of entertainment at my expense to make what would otherwise be a somewhat boring video be less so.
Stay super squeaky.
Take care. Happy gaming all.
Later.